our darkness is just as important as our light. All of the things I saw my family go through, not growing up with the father, my mother being in and out of my life, losing my grandmother at 12 years old, 18 of us living in one household, you know, and that was a lot. You know, I was about 15 when I put out my first single, Just a Friend. I had already been moved away from my family for about, I would say, a year and a half, 2 years. And a lot of people that I was meeting were fresh faces. They had different concepts, culturally completely different. Moving from Baltimore to New Jersey, New York City, completely different place. So I was exposed to much more really quickly. And I saw a lot of the other artists that were in my peers having a lot more fun, you know, being free, careless, you know, whereas I was like taking things very seriously. I was like, look, I grew up in a place where you can't trust everybody. You know, even your own family members are still $100 out of your drawer. In the beginning, I brought that mentality to this new world I was introduced to. And in that way, I guess you could say my darkness was still following me, if you will. It wasn't until I got older and I realized that I have to illuminate these things. If I want to continue to grow, if I want to continue to build, you know, if I want to, you know, leave those demons in the past or either use them, if you will, to dig deeper into my more creative side, my more creative expression. And that's where I thank, you know, God for my experiences. And this is like what Dancing Shadows is all about. You know, it's about those depths and digging through these different dimensions of myself to like find those sweet spots that people will be able to relate to as well. And I think it's very healthy to illuminate those, because not only are you learning more about yourself, but you're starting to relate to other people on a different level, you know? I don't think you can have day without night. I don't think you can have cold without hot. There's just two different polarities. You can't have the masculine without the feminine. So the balance is what's necessary in order to create contrast. And what I think we're living in when we talk about the third dimension is contrast, you know, between dark and light. And in that contrast, there's umpteenth amounts of dimensions and levels that you can create on. It's just about finding what levels are neutral to you, that zero point, you know, neutrality, where you're able to not lose power or gain it, you're just letting it flow, you know?